Jonathan Edwards preached a very unique message that lit the match that ignited the beginning of the Great Awakening. After Jonathan Edwards preached two sermons on justification by faith in November of 1733, he followed up in December with a sermon that had this title of all titles, The Preciousness of Time and the Importance of Redeeming It. And God used this very subject that we're talking about to bring about the spiritual explosion that electrified the colonies in the 1730s. And Jonathan Edwards took the text, Ephesians 5, verse 16, making the most of your time, or redeeming the time. He talked about why time is so precious, because it affects eternity, and because it's so uncertain how much you have, because once you have squandered time, you can never recover it. And Edwards talks about a man could be a wealthy man and lose his entire fortune, but he could regain it. But when a man squanders his time, it will never be recaptured again. It is so precious. And then Edwards talks about who wastes time, and he talks about idleness, and he talked about wickedness, and he talked about various ways that men wasted their time in worldly pursuits that amount to nothing. And then he says, at the end of this sermon, how to improve your time. And I end with this. He says, consider your accountability to God, that you will give an account to God on the last day as a steward before His master for how you used the time that was allotted to you to carry out the work that He gave to you to do. Edwards then reasoned how much time you've already lost. You can't afford to lose any more time. And then he says, come with me to the deathbed and hear a man on his deathbed. He will not talk about making more money. He will not talk about having more land and more houses. He would give his entire fortune to have just a little bit more time. But then Edwards goes for the knockout punch and he says, descend with me now into the bowels of hell and listen to the shrieks and the groans of the damned souls in hell. What they would give for just a moment of time, the very time that you have now, they would give anything and everything if they had but the time and the opportunity that you have now. And then Edwards ends with an appeal to his listeners to be used by God to carry out the purpose and the plan that God has for their life in the time that has been given to them, and not to come to the end of their time and to have so little to show for the use of their life. That is the application for each one of us here today. And it begins with you being a believer in Jesus Christ. And quite frankly, if you've never committed your life to Jesus Christ, you will spend eternity suffering forever. You squandered, you blew your entire life because you just lived for you. And you just lived for temporal things. Some of them may be noble, family. But you didn't live for God. And you didn't live for Jesus Christ. And so this really begins with you being a true believer in Jesus Christ. And for those of us who are believers in Christ, what a stewardship that has been entrusted to us of talent, of treasure, but of time. And I pray that all of us will feel a sense, a healthy sense of the fear of God, that we would invest our time so wisely, and not in what is good or even in what is better. You don't have enough time to live for what's good or even for what's better. You must invest your time in that which is best, which is seeking to glorify God and to live for Him and to carry out the work that the Lord has given you to do while here upon the earth. How short is the time that we have?